I'm going to show you guys how easy it is to upgrade your Tesla Sentry Mode with an SSD. Today, your car comes with a 128 gigabyte USB flash drive. I have a 1 terabyte SSD that I'm going to do an upgrade with that looks like this. I have a few options that you guys can buy to be able to upgrade your Tesla Sentry Mode SSD, and I'll leave them down in the link below.
The biggest reason for upgrading to an SSD is that you can store more footage or data than the standard 128 gigabyte USB flash drive that came with your 2021 and newer Tesla. SSDs can also have faster transfer data speeds than the standard Tesla USB flash drive. And lastly, if you get a good SSD such as the Crucial X9 Pro to the Samsung T7, they will be far more reliable than Tesla's USB flash drive. I recommend getting a SSD that's 500 gigabytes and above. Make sure it supports USB-C to USB 3. I recommend Crucial X9 Pro or the Samsung T7. Tesla has an official 1 terabyte SSD upgrade, but it's a little overpriced, but it takes away the headache of searching for which SSD to buy, and it's a nice fit in the glove box, so this could be a great option for you. I have a 1 terabyte Crucial X9 Pro that I've been using for a year, and it works flawlessly with no issues. If you have a 2021 or newer Tesla, the USB port is in your glove box. Older models can find their USB port in the center console. Now let's safely remove your USB flash drive so it does not get corrupted. To open your glove box, tap the car icon in the bottom left corner and go controls menu, and on the right, tap glove box. Now you have access to remove your USB after we turn of two things. Now in the controls menu on the bottom right, you have two buttons. One says recording, the other says Sentry. You have two processes writing to your USB drive. So you have to make sure to turn off both processes, which is your Dashcam and your Sentry mode, in order to remove the flash drive safely. It's like any computer. You don't want to remove a USB drive from your computer while it's writing because you could corrupt the files. First, tap the Sentry button once and that red light goes away. So now your Sentry mode is off. To turn off Dashcam, it's a little different. You have to press and hold for 1 or 2 seconds until you see a flash. There's the flash, and now recording is paused. Once it's paused, you can safely remove the flash drive. Just make sure both red lights are off. Now you can take the USB plug to your computer, review the footage, and save any clips that you want.
You can see there's no red lights here, so nothing's recording now. That means it's safe to remove your USB. And to remove your USB, it's just this thing over here. So do not throw this away. This is really good to have as a backup just in case your SSD breaks down for whatever reason. It's always nice to have a backup. You can see here I have my Crucial SSD, and it just has a little wire and a little dongle here. So it's a USB-C to USB 3.1. And I'm going to just connect this USB 3.1 into the glove box here. So you can see here, it says it's unavailable, Sentry mode's not on. And then what you want to do is go over to safety, the safety menu. And then you can see here, it says format USB drive to enable dash cam. And that's what you want to do. Once you know you have nothing on there and everything's backed up, if you were using your SSD for another reason, you can click on format USB drive. And here it's going to tell you, are you sure you want to format this USB drive? All the data will be deleted. And so I'm going to click format. And you can see here, it's processing, it's successful. You can go back to controls, and you can see here, it's just paused. And what I'm gonna do to enable it is I'm gonna click Sentry on, and I'm gonna hold down 1 to 2 seconds to turn that back on, and it's recording. make sure you guys do a drive around the block just to make sure that all the clips are recording. And that's it. In just a matter of minutes, you've upgraded your Tesla to an SSD. And now you have access to so many more clips. And it's just a great addition for security for your Tesla. One more pro tip I wanted to show you guys was add a pin to your glove box. What that really means is if you want to have access to the glove box, you have to put in a pin in order to open it. And that's just another security feature to be able to keep that dash cam footage more secure. And also anything else that you want to have in that glove box. In order to do that, all you want to do is go to safety and then just scroll down. And here you can see you have a glove box pin, and then turn that on. And right now you can just set what you want your pin to be. Just for this demonstration, I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, 4. And you set a glove box pin. How that works is you can, again, tap on to the car icon. And then I want to open up my glove box now. So tap on glove box. And you will have to put in a pin. So that means anyone that does not know the pin will not have access to that SSD and or anything in that glove box, and that makes it far more secure. So I'll just put in 1, 2, 3, 4, which was the pin, and my glove box just opened up. So there you have it, guys. I hope this was super helpful for you. Make sure you subscribe for more Tesla tips. Drop a like in there. It would really help me out. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask them down in the comments below. I'll be happy to answer them. I hope you guys really like this video, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.